Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about Node.js MVC architecture. MVC architecture means is nothing but the folder structure which we are going to follow. So where to make a database API call, how to write controllers, how we are going to call the controllers from the routes, just a different fixed set of patterns we are going to create, because Express is kind of open where you can choose your own folder structure, own architecture, but we can just couple things together and we can just create a constant way of writing the Node.js controller, services, the routes. Okay, it's like MVC pattern we are going to create. So whenever the request comes, it is going to the routes. So we already have the routes.js file where we are deciding, okay, where we are creating the Express router instance, and then we are doing router.get, put, post, delete, all these things we are doing. From the router, you will call the controller. So controller is the primary central point. Controller will decide what to render. So based on the request, like if you wanted to render the HTML response, then you can just choose one of your template, the handlebar template, EGS template, or if you wanted to read or write data, then there will be models. So we will be talking about MySQL models, Mongoose models. They will be actually representing the database entities, and controllers will be talking to those models, entity models, to read, write, update, delete, all these kind of operation that will be doing. So it's kind of MVC we are going to structure. Controller will is deciding what data need to be published to the UI, either from the views or either from the models. So it's like a partial MVC structure we are trying to adopt, and the same thing we can actually create in our application. Models, we will not have models. I mean, you can create models when we have the integration with the MongoDB. So basically, currently we have this empty skeleton, okay? From app.js, we are requiring these routes, and in the index.js, we have this empty structure. Now, what you can do is, here we can have a controller. In the controller, you can create index.js, and this time we are trying to create a class. I mean, you can create a functions also, class app controller, and in this class I'm going to have all these methods. Okay, it's like simple create data. Okay, this create data is going to have the request and response in it. So if you what it is going to return is response.status 200.json some payload. Okay, similarly update data, delete data, all these methods we can have. Consider something we have created and how to export it. Module.exports app controller. So this is the class we are exporting from this particular file. Okay, how you can get this file in your routes? You can just so we can just say app controller. And you can do require, and we are requiring controller. So we just need to go step outside and index.js. You don't need to specify index. So here what we will do is, first we will create the instance of controller. New app controller, right? And now we can use this controller instance to call these methods. So in the router, router.get, you can use other layer also, like router do use API, and then further you can call these methods. For now, let's make it simple, router.get API. In that case, let's make it user not API, and here we have a callback. In this callback, I mean simple callback, where we have request and response, and we'll be calling this. So we can just directly call the controller dot create data, and we have to pass request and response again. right? This can be written in the same line. Right, similarly you can define all your routes. This is for, you can have one method get data. If it is not there, we can create. Right, get data. So similarly, this is HTTP get. Here we can have HTTP post, HTTP put. Right, I mean, this is how we can actually structure it. From routes, we are calling controller. Now, this further, it can call to your database service layer. So we can have models that we will talk with MongoDB database. And here, actual what you will do is, you will get the DB instance db.find1, db.model.find1. So you'll be passing the ID, all these things you will do, create data here, you will actually save it. Here you will actually get it based on the ID, like find one. These methods are available in the MongoDB and this is the update one. So from here you are actually calling service. I mean, instead of that, you can actually have one service class also. If you really wanted to achieve it, the whole isolation services, so you can create one folder service, and there you can create index.js, and we can have the same kind of structure there. I'm just putting a dummy structure, but it can be app service. Right, so what we will do is, here we will get only the data, I mean whatever need to be saved in the database. I will just talk about only create data. So now I got the data, and what I will do is return db.model.save this data, just for an example. It will be totally different than this. In the controller, we will create a instance of this. So we have to import service equal to require okay, and here you can create a service instance. Const service equal to new app service. Okay. We got the service instance now, and this can be used here in the create data. Instead of doing this, return service.create data, and here you will be passing the data from request.body, right? And create data will do something like, it will just data db.model.save, right? DB can be MongoDB, MySQL or something. It will just return something. In real world scenario, it will be returning a promise. Then promise is coming here and it is returning back to the controller. So all these will be async await kind of chain we have to write. Then we have to wrap it around the try catch. All these things we will take a look, but this is how this MVC can work. In real world, you will have models. From models, you will actually have an access to the database collection, MongoDB collection or MySQL entity. And this is how you can actually respond to the services. Thanks, everyone.